Hey guys, as you all know, Samsung had a very bad time with the Galaxy Note 7 this year. Even after they discontinued it, a question still remains: what was the cause of explosion? In this video, I have got the most appropriate answer to this question, so stay tuned.
Check.
In September 2016, the first reports of exploding Galaxy Note 7s created a huge buzz on social media. At first, Samsung recognized the issue, which was the manufacturing process of lithium polymer battery by Samsung SDI, where there was too much tension used in its manufacturing. For this, Samsung recalled about 2 million devices to replace them. After a few weeks, Samsung began to ship the replaced Galaxy Note 7 devices with an S on the box. The customers were happy to get their Note 7 back. But after a few days, some of the batteries in the replaced devices also started to explode, which made Samsung to recall the devices again and put an end to the Galaxy Note 7 by stopping its sales and production, without giving any answer to the question, what's making these phones to explode? Not even Samsung engineers, but everyone tried to find out the reason behind its explosion. Many people did several tests on Note 7 to know the cause, but no one came up with an appropriate conclusion. A test was carried out at the Applied Energy Hub Battery Laboratory in Singapore, where they applied pressure on the Note 7's battery. The device gave out smoke and then burst into flames. But then, they concluded that any phone would suffer the same fate after being subjected to such tests, not just the Note 7. A guy did a crazy test on the Galaxy Note 7, which was streamed live on Facebook. He kept his Galaxy Note 7 on charging for more than 20 hours, but nothing happened. Another test was conducted by Mashable, in which the three Note 7 devices were subjected to extreme usage with maximum brightness, so that the devices overheat, but none of them exploded even when the device reached the high temperature. Further, they shined a 1000 watt bulb on them and used extremely keeping them on charging. Even then, no explosion was seen. Then finally, when they placed the Note 7 device directly in front of the 1000 watt lamp, the explosion began. A famous YouTuber, Jerry Rig Everything, conducted a test on the Note 7's battery where he teared down the device and took a close look on the battery setup. Further, he tried poking the battery with blunt tools and the battery caught fire. He concluded that due to the metal impurities in the manufacturing of the battery, the explosion might have occurred. Another YouTuber kept the Note 7 in microwave for few minutes to test whether the device will explode or not. The phone came out dead but did not explode. Even Samsung engineers reported that they could not replicate the Note 7's explosion in their lab, which made it even more difficult for them to find the cause. Even then, Samsung said that it will find the exact cause behind the explosion of Galaxy Note 7 before the end of 2016, as Samsung had to focus on the release of Galaxy S8 next year and also to prevent it from happening in future. A recent report to which many disagreed claimed that the steepest edge, what we all know as the curved design, and the edges might be reason behind Note 7's explosion. As you can see, Galaxy Note 7 being most bigger is the most compact and thinner Galaxy Note ever. According to the report, the isolation plates in the Note 7 device are apparently situated towards the edge of the battery, and when sealing the device tight, the pack might be subjected to a pressure that is higher than the normal at the wrong end. But this was the reason given for the recall devices. So the question still stands, why the new Galaxy Note 7 devices explode? And then, after several days, we got the most appropriate answer to this question. This answer was given by Instrumental, a company specialized in tools and services. What they actually did was, they just acquired a Galaxy Note 7 and a fire extinguisher and tore the device down. They used an instrumental station to document this process. Basically, when the batteries are charged and discharged, chemical processes cause the lithium to migrate and the battery will mechanically swell. Any battery engineer will say you that it's necessary to leave some percentage of ceiling above the battery, take it 10% as a rough figure, and over the time, the battery will expand into the space. A Galaxy Note 7 device without the ceiling was subjected to a test. The battery and adhesive was 5.2 mm thick, which was resting in a 5.2 mm deep pocket. There should have been a 0.5 mm ceiling, which is the basic rule and was neglected in the Note 7 device. So, the packing of the battery was the main cause for all this issue we saw so far with the Galaxy Note 7. If the engineers would have left the required space, then there would not have been chances of exploding devices. So, Samsung should now know that it should not do it with the other Galaxy models and make the future models safe. So, now the only solution for this problem is making the battery smaller, which provides enough space. But making battery smaller also gives less battery life, which I guess no one could compromise. So guys, what do we have to say now? Maybe now, you got the actual cause behind the Note 7's explosion, right? If you agree with the reason I kept in front of you, then give the video a thumbs up. And also, please subscribe to my channel to receive further tech updates. Also guys, I heard that Samsung is disabling Wi-Fi, Bluetooth and cellular networks in the Note 7 devices in Canada to make the devices useless and make the users to return it to them. This is what Samsung said in response to closing connectivity in Canada. We have been in continuous communication with Note 7 customers to remind them about the need to return their recalled devices, and will continue to communicate daily with a push notification about this network deactivation event to ensure that they continue to receive adequate notice. Also guys, if you aren't aware, Samsung has already shut down mobile network access for unreturned Note 7 devices in New Zealand. Also, the latest report says that Samsung is putting an end to the Galaxy Note 7 devices in US from 19th of this month. Samsung had capped the battery percentage to 60% and now Samsung is taking this big step to get back the remaining Note 7 devices. And now Samsung will be releasing an OTA update which will kill the remaining Note 7 devices. Samsung said in a statement that this update will prevent US Galaxy Note 7 devices from charging and will eliminate their ability to work as mobile devices. But Verizon has not participated in this process, and so the Verizon's Galaxy Note 7 devices will not see any such update for now. If you have a Verizon Note 7 device, then you can still use it without any update issues. So guys, this is clear now that Samsung is doing anything possible to take back the devices before the year ends. If you have a Note 7 device in your hands right now, no matter which country you stay in, I prefer you give back the device to the company for safety purposes. What we can do now is hope to see a new, better and a safe Galaxy Note 8 next year. So guys, this was all about the Note 7 I wanted to talk to you all. Please subscribe to my channel to watch tech news, and also please share this video if you liked it.